antique dealers specialized in this business and provided wealthy curious and collectors with these mysterious or evocative artifacts. It is in this context that small crystal skulls said to come from Mesoamerica, attributed to Aztec or Maya civilizations, appeared on the market. These were very different from known pre-Columbian Aztec and Maya artifacts. A lot of different objects coming from these cultures were already well known, from ceramics to masks and jewelry, but no crystal sculptures like these. Maybe several dealers offered them, but the most prominent was a French antiquarian specialized in Mesoamerican antiques, Eugène Boban. He was seen as an authority in the field because he had spent many years in Mexico and spoke fluent Spanish and Nahuatl, the language of the Aztecs that still was and still is spoken in central Mexico. He had provided many authentic pre-Columbian antiques, was part of a scientific commission too, and all of this made him a credible, well-established antiquarian. In 1870, aged 36, he opened a shop in Paris and kept managing this business between Mexico and France for 3 decades. Among other objects, he sometimes had these crystal skulls on offer. We don't know exactly how many he sold, but several that are now in museums were traced back to him. For example, one that is now at the British Museum in London. This one skull appeared in 1881 in Boban's shop. He tried to sell it as an Aztec artifact to Mexico's National Museum, but the offer was rejected. So he turned to New York City, where he sold it to an American entrepreneur. The skull changed hands and then ended up in an auction, where it was bought by Tiffany & Co., the jewelry house, and Tiffany sold it to the British Museum in 1897.